We've done a lot of events, and before I do them, I always ask the person who I'm about to introduce, what can I say about them? No one has ever said, it's just about the project. And I pushed him on it. I was like, no, come on, really. What do you want me to say about you? And he was like, really, just nothing, just talk about the project. And I think that says an awful lot about this filmmaker, Sebastian.
Yeah.
Project, you may have already seen, but from the trailer, I haven't seen it, but I think that this is clearly an ambitious project, a meaningful one. I'm moved already, and now you really should hear from the filmmaker.
Yes. Yeah, it's so cool. When I moved here, actually, when I visited Los Angeles before moving here, and I thought, this is really my idea of Los Angeles. It was like film and the fireplace and outdoor. And then I moved here, and people were like, oh, I'm having my birthday. Do you want to come to my birthday? And I said, I would love to come to your birthday. I don't even know you. And they said, well, it's at this club, and it's $40 to get in, and it's a two-drink minimum. This is crazy. So I don't ever go out. And so then, you know, a dear friend of mine who's in the film tonight, who's written 10 books on love, Marianne Williamson, he's a dear friend of Roger's as well, and that's how we connected. So, for Roger, who has us all here to his home. Somebody wants to save the dolphins, or they want to stop trafficking of girls from South America, or they want to save the polar ice caps, and they go out, and they're completely crazy, and they sell their home and their car, and they, you know, say, this is it, this matters to me, and then they find out that there's absolutely no way to make a dollar. So, what you're about to see tonight is a very humble documentary film. It's the first part of two films, and the second one we're shooting already right now. This one is What's Love, What's Purpose of Life, What's Heaven, What's Hell, and What's Intimacy. And the next one is What's God, What's Spirituality, and What's Religions. And really, it's like you think about all the paintings, and all the books, and all the songs that have been written about that, that it's something that's so kind of immediately we know what love is, and yet we go out in the world and you see that everyone's giving the finger to each other in traffic, right? Or, you know, there's war everywhere. We have someone that we care for, that we're related to. We can't seem to strike a common chord to continually get along. So I think that was the exploration with this film. So cool to see other people, such a cool room of an open air room of people who are interested in driving consciousness evolution and interested in questions like this.
I found some of the people you interviewed so just touched me deeply. Like Richard Chamberlain, to me, he was just so present to the whole essence and feeling of what he was saying and being it. It's like, what does it take for us to really be it? And yeah, it is scary, I think, for me, you know. And I just, that stuff, I just really applaud that, and what you did to get those moments.
So it was a crazy, eclectic group of people. It must have been a lot of fun to do that. I kind of got two questions. One, were there any surprises where someone said something, you're like, whoa! Like, wow, that. And then the other one was, I'm sure there were many, but one of those big aha moments where you're just like you were talking about those breakthroughs or something where something just tinged and it resonated to you really well.
There's always something else that I get out of it. Yeah, it's like if you kiss your love or you hug your child, right? And it's always the same, but it's always different. And I think that to the degree that I'm present, to the degree that I can let go and collaborate in this moment, when I watch the film or I listen to interviews, to that direct degree, I experience something new and a new aha moment kind of every single time, right? Like with a sunset or something like that. Like, it's as spectacular as I'm gonna allow it to be. And I'm ready for it to be spectacular. Hell yeah.
By a certain age, I've been enchanted and kind of not disenchanted, but a little bit disinterested with the world in some aspect. And having a kid makes you kind of fall in love with the world again, because you get a chance to kind of push it, or bring the world in through their eyes again, and re-enchant the world. So there it is.
I find that some of the answers to this those questions to love, yeah, that really touch me deeply are when it's more in my face as being something different than what I expected. Like, I've done over the past number of years a certain amount of work in prison. And I have a program that's a life skills program, and I brought it to this one prison for women. It breaks down the preconceptions of what I might find in a prison and who someone might be as a lifer and what that can mean. It breaks down so much. And that, to me, is what love can do, breaking down the illusions and the barriers.
I've got a long meditative practice, but I think that part of it, after 5 years, after a decade, I realized that it's really about bringing that practice into each moment, right? So looking into your eyes, being here now, and then also bringing simultaneously the pain, holding that winter always a little bit in every single moment.
We all got a chance to see the hugs at the end. And was that what the process was like the whole way through, or did stuff come up that maybe put the lie to the experience, or what can you say about that, Jason?
It was very natural, just like it was on screen. It turns out people really like to talk about issues of depth and substance. Particularly, we were interviewing a lot of people that are, in the arts or are known for a particular book or something like that, who, do a lot of interviews and processes, but they don't get asked these types of questions.
If you found the process itself rewarding, since there's not a lot of financial gain, if you liked it enough to continue making documentaries, I think you answered that. You do.
Yeah, it's the only documentary project I've been involved with. I've got another film that I'm producing. It's optioned from a book that's published in 20 languages. It's called Grace and Grit. And it's an epic, sweeping love story written by Ken Wilber.
Thank you all so much for coming.
Thank you.